A vacuum sealer was a big hit in our kitchen. It makes frozen things last longer and take less space in the freezer. This is one of the most common style vacuum sealers with one button for vacuum sealing and one button for only sealing. These use textured bags that come in form of either bags with one open end or in tubes which one can cut and seal to create different lengths for different needs, all from one roll. Couple of times the seal has leaked and air has gotten into the bag after a couple of hours or days. In this video I'll share how I have modified my vacuum sealer to achieve better seals and hopefully getting rid of this problem. I have created modified logic board for this specific sealer, and as I'm trying to improve my home edged PCB process, I have made this one at home. If I'm happy with this modification, I will eventually order professionally made one from the sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. I have been happy with their services in previous sponsored and non-sponsored projects, so I can highly recommend them for your projects as well. Firstly, let's address the problem at hand. The vacuum sealer, while being easy to use and quite simple machine, sometimes fails to seal the bags properly. This is often caused by contamination or wrinkles in the bag at the line where the heat sealer tries to close it. To overcome this limitation, I have implemented a double sealing feature with my own timer board. Before taking this machine apart, I wasn't sure what features I would like to add. I knew basic functionality should stay the same. But when I opened the case, I noticed the power supply with relays and other main components are on one port, and user interface and timer is on the separate PCB. All the wires between those ports were labeled, and that made this modification relatively easy. All I needed to do was to remove the original timer board, design a similar one that uses reprogrammable microcontroller, the AT1085 in this case, and I could easily modify this vacuum sealer to match my needs. In my modified controller, the basic functionality is the same as in the original, but if I press start and seal buttons at the same time, the vacuuming process will be followed by not just one, but two 3-second long sealing cycles with 3-second cooling period between them. Double sealing is a common way of decreasing possibility of leaking seal in vacuum sealed bags. I have also reduced minimum delay between two manual sealing cycles to 3 seconds, from original 15 or 20 seconds. While this modification requires creating new PCB, replacing the original one, this wasn't too bad for electronics hobbyist. All the complicated parts were left alone in their separate PCB. This isn't possible with every model, but I got lucky with this one. The circuit is simple as it gets. The 5-pin connector has 5V and ground for powering this board. Then there are pins for controlling heating element, and vacuum pump motor. Both go to transistor space through resistor in the other PCB. Then there's one pin for vacuum switch. That vacuum switch connects this pin to ground when appropriate vacuum has been reached. I didn't want need to control LEDs independently from the control signals, so they are connected to the pins that control heating element and vacuum pump. Then there are 3 buttons connected to GPIO pins. With internal pull-ups, there's no need for them on the board. Now, important thing, I am using PB5 pin as input, so I had to disable the reset functionality by programming the 8085's fuses. This also disables the in-circuit programming, so be sure to program working firmware before flashing those fuses. The code may seem mismatched with if statements and for loops, but that's okay. It does what I wanted it to do. First I set vacuum and seal control pins as outputs, leaving other pins inputs. Then I enable internal pull-ups for all the inputs. In the main while loop, I check if vacuum button is pressed and turn the pump on if it is pressed. During vacuuming, this for loop runs over and over again, checking for inputs. If stop button is pressed, the process is stopped without setting the vacuum reached flag. If a vacuum sensor signals that the vacuum has been reached, the flag is set and this for loop is stopped. Pressing the seal button during vacuuming process can do 2 different things. If vacuum button is pressed at the same time, double sealing function is activated after the vacuuming. If vacuum button is not pressed, vacuum reached flag is set and for loop is stopped. What happens after the for loop depends if the vacuum has reached during that for loop or not. If a vacuum was reached, either indicated by the sensor or by user pressing the seal button, sealing process starts. If double sealing feature is activated, the sealing will happen twice. But if the vacuum process isn't active, pressing the seal button runs sealing process. In the sealing function, I turn heating element on for a predefined time, then disable vacuum pump and heater. Keeping the vacuum pump running during the first sealing was how the original timer worked. In the end of sealing function, I've added delay of 3 seconds, defined in the beginning of this file. This is for cooling period, preventing from overheating things by running heater too often. This was another case of solving I wish this device could do this and that, by taking the device apart and figuring out how it works. Modifying, repairing and creating new are all something I enjoy as electronics hobbyist. Even if this modification doesn't apply to your vacuum sealer, I hope this video was interesting or inspirational. See you next video. Thanks.